As I get older, it seems my well-meaning aunts always ask, when are you gonna have a baby? You're not gonna be young forever. Well, Aunt Gail, I might not be young forever, but there is a way I could keep my eggs young for quite some time. Hey everyone, Julia here for DNews. Over 30 years ago, doctors successfully grew an embryo from a frozen egg. Back then, it was considered experimental and used for women who might undergo chemotherapy or other medical procedures that might harm their eggs. These women could freeze their eggs and use them at a later date. Now it seems to be all the rage. Women delay pregnancy for all sorts of reasons, like focusing on school or career or just waiting for somebody to settle down with. But they still worry about fertility, so now the egg freezing trend is taking off. One egg freezing company hosted a cocktail party in New York to advertise their business, and big tech companies like Apple gives its employees up to $20,000 towards egg freezing as a health benefit. While it's growing more common, it's still really expensive. It can take about $10,000 just to freeze your eggs, then a few hundred more bucks just to store them every year, and a couple more thousand to thaw them and undergo in vitro fertilization treatments. So it still remains a treatment mostly for the wealthy. And besides the cost, it's a pretty intensive process. It's not like they just pluck out your eggs and put them in a freezer. Nope, you have to take hormones for a few weeks to stimulate the ovaries to release a few eggs, which can leave you feeling bloated and a little bit off. You get regular checkups to see how the eggs are coming along, and then the procedure to remove the eggs sounds not that nice at all. It's kind of like drawing blood. A needle has to pierce your vaginal wall and reach the ovarian follicles and retrieve the egg. Okay, ouch, thank God you're under a little anesthesia. Once the eggs are removed, they're cooled to sub-zero temps and stored. But the freezing process does a little bit of damage. It makes the shells harden, which can make fertilization a little tricky. But using a technique similar to IVF, sperm can be directly inserted into an egg, bypassing the hardened shell. But since this whole thing is kind of new, no one really knows how long eggs are good for, although one clinic successfully used 7-year-old eggs. The process can't boast a high success rate. According to the American Society for Reproductive Medicine, one egg has a 2 to 12% chance that it will develop into a fetus. So doctors recommend freezing a few eggs. Some women freeze a dozen or so for later use. So with all the high cost and low chances, why do people do it? Freezing your eggs is a kind of pause on fertility. Women are born with all the eggs they'll ever have. They don't produce them throughout their lives like men produce sperm. So you either use them or you lose them. According to the American Society for Reproductive Medicine, women are most fertile in their 20s. Fertility declines gradually through the 20s and 30s, but the decline picks up speed as women enter their late 30s. As a woman ages, she loses her eggs through ovulation and through a process called atresia, which is a gradual loss of egg-containing follicles. Even the eggs that remain degrade over time, and the risk of birth defects increases. By the time a woman is in her 40s, only 10% of her eggs are good, and the chance of a successful fertilization drops to below 5%. With chances this low, it's no wonder women hedge their bets by freezing their younger, healthier eggs. While this might seem like a ladies only issue, gentlemen, you shouldn't wait to have kids either. Check out this video here to find out why.
Other studies from the last decade have found that as men get older, random mutations appear in their sperm cells, which might be a cause of the increased risk of autism.
Would you ever freeze your eggs, or do you have another science question? We'll save some of your best questions to answer in future videos. So like this video and subscribe to our channel so you don't miss your answer. And as always, thanks so much for watching DNews.